Hey everyone, I'm Michael Majors.
And I'm Ross Merriam.
And you're watching the Versus series on StarCityGames.com. All right, back here in the Versus series, a little standard action leading into Richmond. Man, Ross, I haven't seen you in a minute.
I know. More than feels like forever.
It's been like a month?
Yeah, I think I almost forgot what you look like. But now really? I have your wonderful smiling face across
from me. Thanks. I don't smile that much, though. Don't lie.
Well, I try to bring it out in you.
So look at me. I'm just smiling. I appreciate that. Thanks, Ross.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder.
That's what they say. But today we're playing some lists that performed well at the Invitational last week. I'm going to have a little bit of fun with Zach Elsick's Green-Blue Crush deck that went 7-1.
And I am going to be the villain with Chris Van Meter's deck that playing Bant Company that also went 7-1 or better. I don't remember the exact record. But he did really well in standard.
Yeah, both these guys did good. Their decks look sweet. I mean, we've seen this stuff before. It's kind of odd that Green Blue Crush is like kind of normal, but it is now.
Yeah, it sort of gained a few extra tools from Eldritch Moon that have moved it from really on the outside to like a legitimate fringe archetype. It sort of blended some elements from the mono blue Prism Ring deck that we saw a couple months ago. And made this sort of ramp crush kind of dig through my deck with pieces of the puzzle craziness.
And people will kind of figure out how to build it, I think. Like, Send to Sleep is a really cool addition because this deck is, like, pretty good at getting, like, a giant monster on the board, but then, like, Send to Sleep, like, closes out the game, and then simultaneously it also just, like, buys you time to, like, get to your big engine cards. So I think that's a really smart addition.
Yeah, the deck definitely had some issues closing games once it cast its big spells, so.
Yep. Hopefully I don't screw it up too bad. It is a pretty tough deck to play, so we'll see.
You've been playing Crush of Tentacles for a while, so
trying to play Crush of Tentacles for a while.
I'm confident you'll be able to give the people what they want.
Yeah, and then Chris's list looks like pretty typical, less interaction, which is kind of a trend we're starting to see. Like Paul Rietzel kind of led the charge for zero Dromoka's Command. Chris is playing two, but you know, just a lot of creatures, very streamlined.
It gives you a bit more flexibility in the main deck when you cut down on Dromoka's Commands. You can more easily fill your sort of quota for Collected Company. Chris is elected to play a couple of copies of Archangel Avacyn in the main. He's got some Ojitize Commands on the board. We've seen some of those swap around a bit, but all in all, doesn't stray too far from the mold that we've seen over the last 4 to 6 months.
Yep, exactly. All right, let's roll some dice.
Yeah. I haven't done poker hand in so long.
I did it about 2 hours ago.
It's a weird sevens and elevens game. I don't really understand it. Pair of twos.
I'm so bad at rolling dice. It is unbelievable.
Oh, wait. No, mine's a pair of ones, too. Sorry.
Oh, you have a kicker,
No, but
though.
I have six, yeah.
I lose again.
Here for game one, and we have both mulligan to six, and I have a very good six-card hand. We've got plenty of stuff to do with our mana, and I will easily keep.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty happy with this six as well. I guess I could just, like, brick off and die, but, you know, whatever.
Yeah. Scry, and... That is an interesting one, because keeping it will put us off curve on two, but makes us more likely to hit more land drops. Given that our hand is a lot of twos, I am inclined to just shuffle it away, which means it doesn't really matter what I do with it.
Okay. Mine's an easy keep. Obviously, okay. I need this for my hand of function.
I'll play Vol of the Wilds. And
go.
Get a Plains. No. So, in this matchup, I definitely think I want to be putting a lot of pressure on Michael, so putting myself off curve is something I really want to avoid, and perhaps I get punished for it, but it is a risk I will take.
Draw card.
Yep.
Go.
Attack.
Yep.
Self of Spirit.
Yep.
You can go. You're at 18. Lumbering Falls is a great draw.
Go.
Oof. Attack for 4.
All right. 14.
Forest go. Scott nothing. So unlucky.
If my veggies get spell quallered, then I'm probably just dead, so we'll see what happens.
Well, I'll spell qualler it.
Alright. Go.
Already have a selfless spirit down. I guess spirit's not great at protecting it from crush of tentacles, but what are you gonna do?
Eight. I'm at eight.
You can go.
Alright, try this again, veggies.
So there's no chance of you being able to crush or anything. You could send a sleep if this resolves. I'll just try to hit a spell caller.
Yep.
Okay, I will put in these two and bounce the Elvish Visionary. Prevent any chump blocks. Send a sleep here will only let Michael survive at two, and that is if I don't have a blue source for this Lumbering Falls.
Yep, go ahead. Upkeep. Just go ahead and do it now. Give Ross one less draw step at a spell caller. Target, Advocate, and Thalia, I guess.
Yeah. Actually, I guess I could try to draw an untapped blue source or try to cast this collected company into...
Oh, that is a reasonable consideration.
Another spell queller.
But I guess if I leave this untapped, then Dramoka's command kills me, so yeah, whatever.
So yeah, well, I could just try to hit another spell queller, is my...
Or... Oh, never mind. Okay. Yeah, for some reason, I was thinking you could legend roll out of it, but no. You can't.
So it's either six draws to a three outer or one draw to certainly a less than 18 outer. So my chances of winning the game immediately are better by casting Collected Company here, but I think I'm far enough ahead that I don't want to take the chance of bricking and then actually like having
holding and getting crushed is worse. Right?
Yeah, exactly. Or casting
and getting crushed.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I think I just want to avoid that. And I will attack for six.
All right, two.
You can go.
Okay. Wheel? I guess this is sort of a route. I don't know. Target my...
Probably just a forest, right?
I don't know. I'm not really sure how I beat a collected company here. I guess I need to draw another send to sleep. But I probably need more than that still. I guess these two aren't untapping. I don't think Lumbering Falls accomplishes anything, especially with these in our hand. I mean, I guess theoretically, that gives us lethal if we can find... Okay, I guess if we find Send Asleep, then this can represent lethal. So I guess I will target this.
Okay.
Okay. Take my
turn. It's exiled?
Yeah. All right. Let's see here. What does that do? Let's see. So one mana off right now. All right. Whatever. I don't think this is getting any better. Really just my best option. So I could just do this, try to spike Send to Sleep. I could hit a land and then do this and try to hit Send to Sleep. I guess. I don't know. Alternatively, I could do these two plus this and actually try to work towards something that just gets me out of this naturally, like a crush or something. Maybe that's just a higher percentage play in general, so I guess I'll do this. Again, I don't know. Alright, play site beyond site.
So you look at the top two. It's just sleight of hand twice, right?
Correct.
Sure.
Okay. All right. What does this do? 2, 3, 4, 5. I guess this is better.
Oh, the other goes.
I guess this is better. This deck is hard. I'm also clueless. It's not a good combination.
And you don't have any clues?
No, I don't.
We're both clueless, though. No Max McVetties for anybody.
Oh.
There's so many sitting over here.
Oh, man, this is really hard. 1, 2, 3. Morph up. Send to sleep. That doesn't get me out of anything, though. I guess I just have to take this. All right. Let's put this on the bottom. And then I will play a land and part.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Here we go. Trigger. Probably just the land is better. I haven't. There's no way I can think far ahead enough in advance to figure out if that's actually true, but I'll take the land. Dressed up.
Visionary.
I'll crush first.
Ooh. And then you get to veggies.
Yep. Give him my octopus, and then I'll veggies.
Now you have two blockers. I guess you'd be dead to Reflector Mage still. I guess any two creatures because I'm holding Reflector Mage that you know about. So still not in great shape.
No. I'm not.
You took so many turns.
I did. And then I will play Elvish Visionary.
You're about to cast Elvish Visionary for the second time. That usually ends the game, in my experience.
Visionary?
Yeah.
Okay, Frosted Spellcord, that we would have died. Visionary.
Have you played a land yet?
No.
You have two cards in hand?
I have two cards.
Sure.
Go.
Perhaps I should have spoke. I didn't want to let your talking
what I said influence you. What a nice guy.
Well, I'll play Collected Company.
Sure. Am I doing it? Oh, I took three part the water veils and utter nonsense.
I'll take those two and search for forest.
Okay. I will take this opportunity to tap them down. I still don't think I'm winning.
But... Yeah, I just have Reflector Mage still. You have one card in hand.
Yeah.
Is if you draw another Crush.
Yeah, I need to draw another big spell.
Dim
Protector, Send to Sleep, or Crush, you're all good.
Okay, Sylvan Advocate and Reflector Range the Octopus.
Not my Lumbering Falls?
Yeah, I probably should just hit the Lumbering Falls. I keep thinking it's Expert, but you don't have mana.
Yep.
So if I do that, then... Yeah, we'll definitely do that. That's just far and away the biggest thing. I could even just take 8 from your... Take 10 from this attack and be fine.
Okay. Play Oath. Didn't protect her. Oh. Sad. I am dead.
Yeah, my things are untapping.
Alright, back here for game 2. I'm on the play. Hand looks pretty acceptable, so I'll keep.
My hand is not great, but I think it's still a keep. It should do enough with a couple lands.
That's a good draw. Go.
Duskwatch. That fast you played that, I thought my thing was getting countered.
I think this is better. Oh, this is certainly interesting, but I don't think we need it. So I'll just take this one. I will pilgrimage, and then it'll be your turn.
Attack for two. Yep. Tracker.
Yep.
You're 18. You can go.
Let's go ahead and keep setting up. Play veggies. Go.
Yeah, this game is not going well. Maybe I need to mulligan aggressively to disrupt your...
It's like... The only thing you can draw is Spokeweller that just actually stops the ramp.
Yeah. Which is why I kept my hand. Now he's clueless. Not me. I'll play Duskwatch and bash and pop this clue. Now I am. You take 6.
Yep, 12.
You can go. Should just pop the clue first, I guess, in case I draw like Advocate or Selfless Spirit, something I'd rather play than the second Duskwatch.
But okay, and this is the part of the game where I don't know what I'm doing again.
This is the part of the game where it's easy. You just play your awesome spells.
I don't have any of those. Well, I kind of do, but not really.
If you don't have any awesome spells, that's just bad deck building.
I guess we'll lead on... So I guess I could go, like, play this down... And then this or something like that. So maybe it just gives me more options if I just lead on this. I think that's true.
Lead on the scariest card.
Okay. And then...
And crush.
Now I'm just going to sight beyond sight. Go. And then upkeep. I'm going to... Send asleep these.
I will quell that.
Sure.
And I will draw. And I will get a clue.
Yep.
I will bash.
I assume there's not much benefit for me to chump block here. So I can just go to 4. This is better if I find crushes and things along those lines. Don't think there's too much difference between 4 and 8, especially because Ross doesn't have a Lumbering Falls. So, yeah, I'll just take it.
Sack and...
Or 3, rather.
Yeah. Have you take 9?
Yep.
You get a 3. You can go.
All right. Sight. That's interesting. Yeah, I guess that's pretty good. Yeah, take that. Maybe it was wrong for me not to chump now, but I don't know. All right, play Nissa's Renewal.
You go to 10?
Yep. Assume I'm supposed to just get islands basically every time. Go to 10, I'll play an island and then play a morph. Doesn't leave me dead, right? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Yeah. So I guess Reflector Mage plus Jeroka's Command kills me. I mean, maybe I'm supposed to just like time walk here, but I think this is better. I'm not sure. Feels like if I just like time walk, then like I'm not actually pulling ahead. I'm just getting a draw step, basically.
You're probably just gonna end up doing the same thing on your time walk turn. Yeah.
But maybe that is a reason to chump block this turn. But I thought Sight Beyond Sight gave me a pretty good shot at hitting Crush, which maybe could do something with this.
I have Command Reflector Range.
Okay. I don't know. So, yeah, maybe I just screwed this up too. But all right, back here for sideboarding. Hope I'm not screwing this up too much. Probably am. But basically, the idea is with like Noose Constrictor, Clip Wings, and to a lesser extent Dispel, I can kind of slow down the game. I'm not just going to get like hammered over the head with like random 2/3s anymore. I have a little bit more insurance against Spellqueller to actually get my ramp online. So I think because I have these options, I can board out a little bit more of like my air and my like cantrip, Selfish Visionary. Dim Protector is obviously super important to this deck, but it's really bad against Spell Queller, and I think I can go down to three, because generally it's not a very good card in this matchup. Send to Sleep, this might be a mistake to board out. I still have two in my deck, but again, because I have like more options to actually not just get hit repeatedly every single turn, I don't think they're as important. Then like Nissa's Renewal, Part of the Water Veil, Sight Beyond Sight. Kind of assuming because Nissa's Renewal and Sight Beyond Sight are just one-ofs, they're not too critical. Like, obviously, I can't board out all my ramp because it's just such an important part of the deck, but these are kind of like the most expensive, clunky options for looking at more cards and getting more lands on the battlefield. And then, presumably, if the game slows down, I don't need all my Part of the Water Veils to actually win. This might... If there anything is like a huge pun on my part, it's probably boarding out this card. But we'll see how it goes.
Yeah, it makes sense. You're just lowering your curve generally, and just trying to make the game play out and get to your end game slower, but because you have to spend time interacting with me anyway. So so cutting your more expensive spells makes a lot of sense. And
yeah. Hopefully I won't be at four life when I get to my end game, basically.
Yeah. And sideboarding on my side is a lot easier. Obviously, the counter spells are excellent. And then I'm bringing in Gideon as an additional threat. It's a threat that I can land, hopefully, before Michael's able to set up the Crush of Tentacles. And once it's in play, it can do all the heavy lifting by itself, and it can hold up mana for either Counterspell for a key spell or for Dromoka's Command or Archangel Avacyn to follow up. So I have some pressure on the board after immediately following a Crush of Tentacles, and I'm not put too far behind by it. And then cutting Dromoka's Command for obvious reasons against a Creature Light deck. Even though Michael's bringing in Noose Constrictor, Command is pretty poor against Noose Constrictor, so this is an easy cut. And then against a deck with essentially all basic lands except for two Lumbering Falls and one Yavimaya Coast. Lumbering Falls enters.
Four Lumbering Falls.
I thought it was only two. Well, Lumbering Falls enters enters the battlefield tapped regardless. So Thalia really just doesn't do much
of anything. Yeah.
It's just
four Warpath. Lumbering Falls, a Skyline Cascade, and one Yavimaya Coast that can actually hit.
Yeah. So it's just a Warpath Ghoul with first strike. So that's the easiest threat to cut. We saw in the first couple of games. Bantech looked pretty good, so I don't really feel a need to go too crazy into sideboarding, and hopefully a couple counter spells will allow me to keep putting Michael under some pressure and then be able to deal with his really big spell once he sets it up.
Yep. All right, let's get to it. All right, back here for game two. Mulligan to six, and my hand's a little sketchy, but hopefully this combination will buy me some time to get there. I don't know.
I'm also on six cards. My hand is a huge risk, but if I hit, I essentially have the best possible curves, so I don't think I can mulligan.
Crap. This is weird. This doesn't actually, like, enable my hand. Obviously, I really need to find green mana, but I do think this card is good with the way the game is going to play out. And I do have this to basically give me four shots at it, so I think I want to keep this card. Could be wrong, though.
Okay. Well, my card is exactly what I needed, so I'll keep.
Oh, so I'm dead, is what you're saying.
Okay. If all the wilds go.
Okay. Go.
I'll find a forest. And.
Fans of Blue Green Crush, I'm sorry. I know I'm butchering this.
Sylvan Advocate.
Yep.
You can go.
Oh, come on, Deck. Come on. Stop it. I don't know what to do. I assume I don't want another big thing. If I hit a land, then I can play this, and then I have another land drop guaranteed. I feel like this is the card that works best with the rest of the cards in my hand, so I'm going to take this. Thank you.
That's good.
All right, go.
Attack for two.
Yep.
You're at 18. Specifically played Island last turn in case I drew Fortified Village. Got paid off.
Genius.
I'll pass the turn.
Okay, 18. Noose Constrictor.
I will just call the first thing I see.
Noose Constrictor.
Okay, then. You have three cards in your hand?
Yep. suddenly attacking doesn't look so bad for you, does it?
Well, I'm going to try to dig for a Reflector Mage
anyway.
Please
don't. Please don't. Come on. Give me a shot. Reflector Mage just kills me, I think, but if Ross can't attack this turn, then maybe I have a chance. And if he's slow rolling me right now, he's a jerk.
Well, okay, I can show you this one. This is which one I want to put next to it.
All right.
I'm not at all sure. I would assume that I want one that can at least attack into Nissa, so probably not this one, even though I would like the extra land that my Nissa provides. But I think I'll just go with the second advocate.
All right.
So that's your thing. Attack for 4.
Yep, 14.
You can go.
I think if I draw a land, then I'm supposed to hold this, but we'll see. Okay. I think this is correct, but again, who knows? Go.
Draw.
Yep.
Declare attacks. Yep. Send with everybody.
14. Blocking seems so bad. So, regardless of whether I block or not, I can never beat a counterspell. I don't know. So if Ross just has like a creature, maybe I can beat a company. Maybe. Because I'll get my Noose Constrictor back.
You'll have so many extra cards in your hand.
And I'll be at 6 after this attack. And I don't think there's a big difference between 6 and 8, but I guess if Ross hits like Sylvan Advocate plus Reflector Mage off of a company. I mean, I'll still have an 8-8.
What are the odds of me doing that twice?
Pretty high.
Yeah, collect company does do that.
I don't know. I think I'm supposed to block, but I really don't know.
You go to 8?
Yeah.
Play off my Coast and Pass?
That's not good. All right, Oath of Nissa.
Sure.
Take this island. I will play it and then Surge Crush.
Yep.
Okay. So I have a Noose Constrictor. This is in my hand. Have it 8-8 and pass.
And step. Collect a company. Could have tried to find a spell queller for the oath. That just doesn't do anything. Yeah. You still get to Surge. Oh no. Oh no.
Come on. Yes. Okay. All right, so the way this played out here, it is bad that I chump blocked with my Nissa, but I think there was more dangerous scenarios than this one.
Okay, I will play Reflector Mage Advocate, bounce the Octopus.
Yep.
And I can do that without taking damage. And you can go.
Okay. Just play Oath. Take this island, and I think I just want to go ahead and do this again because it actually sets me up pretty well for the following turn. So I'll surge this, and I think I can safely go ahead and just cast my oath again. Just use my mana better. And there's Den Protector. Okay, we're in business. Your turn.
Okay, I will Reflector Major, Octopus, and pass the turn.
It's interesting. I'll play Noose Constrictor.
That's fine.
I'll play Noose Constrictor.
That is also fine.
Okay.
You have 3 guards?
Yep.
Okay, so I can almost start trading down. Just trade Reflector Mage for a card on Michael's hand.
Is it that bad?
I mean, I just have a million cards in hand.
You do?
I'm going to start playing Advocates that I'd like to be able to get through Noose Constrictor. So, and you know I have a bunch of Advocates and Spellqueller for your Den Protector.
Oh, I know.
So I think just trading this for another card seems fine. Oh, let's try it.
Is doubling better than single? I don't think so. I guess, like, if I wanted to try to play around Dromoka's Command, but... Yeah, whatever. Double.
This one first.
All right.
Sure. And yeah, I think that's a deck that really wants all of its stuff, so... Playing Advocate, and I'll pass. Really just hoping to draw lands here because there's so much action in our hand, but... For now, I think we're okay.
Go.
End of turn, Collective Company.
Crap.
Okay. So both those things have reach. Selfless Spirit seems quite poor. So I think I'll just find these two, and I'll search for a forest.
Yeah, I'm just going to get worn out. Maybe this is a scenario where, like, maybe I just can't trump block with Nissa because of this exact scenario. It's just like, I just have to take more of a risk and... Just like, don't really know how I'm supposed to beat Spellqueller with Protector. Like,
So I'll get a clue, I'll flip Nissa.
Yeah.
And kind of want to just make a 4-4. Yeah, I have plenty to do with my mana.
Can't beat it, so...
You have 3 cards in hand?
Yeah, 3 cards.
And... Which means if I attack with both, you essentially have 7 power, and I have 8 toughness, so there's no way you can kill both of my things. So, at best, I think I'm making fine trades, so... I will attack.
Yep, double advocate.
This one first.
Alright.
Yeah, you just take 3.
Okay.
I'm just going to leave up as much mana as I can. 5. You go to 5. And do I even need to play anything else? So I can quell Advocate, and then you can still have enough mana to surge a Crush. So I think I can just pass the turn.
More.
What are you even getting back with it?
I don't know.
Well, I can safely afford to quell her regardless, so. I'll quell your morph.
Okay.
And this means if anything goes wrong, the Dem Protector is going to come back face up, so I've effectively neutered it anyway.
Pilgrimage.
That's fine. You're at 5.
Your turn.
You have Spell Mastery, by the way.
I know. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, you play it. Okay.
Yeah.
Don't want to pop that clue.
Upkeep.
Yep.
Clip Wings.
I will cast Clash of Wills for a reasonable number.
Okay. I'm going to assume I punted this one. All right. It's game 4. I'm gonna try to prove something this game. Turn this around. I think this hand's fine, but I don't know anything anymore.
Well, my hand is a little slow, but it is very powerful, so I'm going to keep.
All right. Coming out of the gates this time. Okay.
Yeah, you got 3 cards.
Yeah, thanks.
How good would Oath of Nissa be if it just drew a card?
I think I just want the Slumbering Falls, so go.
Okay, not the best of draws, but we'll manage.
Interesting. I don't really see the need to go ahead and do this, so I'll just play a Falls Pass.
Very much like a 2-drop.
If you didn't have a 2-drop, I would actually feel good about this game.
Well, I don't have a 2-drop.
Okay. Things are looking good. Get my Nissa down, get my forest, working towards bigger and better things. It's your turn.
Yeah. Maybe this is a hand I can only keep on the play. This feels bad right now. I would like to just pass the turn here. But then Michael probably just does the same thing. He just passes the turn and doesn't play into our potential spell caller.
Sounds great. Let's do it.
And if I do cast something, Michael casts Explosive Agitation, so I feel really far behind. I think I can still slow play this because of my hand.
All right. Yep. Go.
Yeah, probably doesn't want to attack. You can go.
Anticipate.
Sure. I even had something to do on my turn. Okay.
Feels pretty close.
This might be a tough game.
This card is definitely good given the presence of this in our hand. I'm also not sure how important it is that we just have this card in general. I think it's generally pretty important. But considering we're under no pressure and this card works well with her, then I think I'll just take it. I mean, there Nissa is in the name of both of them. I should probably just take it. All right, I'll play. Elvish Visionary.
So you haven't played your land yet. That's fine. Don't want to let a Nissa's Pilgrimage resolve trying to
go
be a Visionary. I hope this doesn't get dispelled.
Yes.
Yeah, it got dispelled.
We're doing it.
This has gone as badly as possible.
Yes. I can see it. I can see a one next to my name.
You have five cards in hand?
I do.
Okay. How can I get out of this?
I don't know. I'm really bringing the pressure here.
I have to get some pressure down to hopefully contend with this Nissa. So I think I have to play a Tireless Tracker, play Coast, get a clue, and pass the turn.
All right, I'll anticipate.
I'm just going to clash this because I'm not sure if I'm going to get another opportunity to use this Clash of Wills. And hopefully that anticipate was digging for something important.
I don't know, maybe.
Yeah, see, at this point, that Clash is probably not doing enough.
Trigger Nissa. I don't think there's anything I can actually do that's relevant for 3 mana other than, like, draw another Pilgrimage, so maybe I should just play this Lumbering Falls.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Let's see. Ashaya probably makes it to where there's no way that Nissa can die. And given what we're working with right now, which things are going smoothly, I'm not going to lie, but it still doesn't look that good. I think I just want to make Ashaya go.
Okay. I'll reflect your Mage of the Ashaya, attack your Nissa, and play a Plains, get a second clue.
Okay, so our Nissa would have died. You did good, did good. Okay, here we go. Okay, another land, not what I needed. Plus. Come on, deck. There we go. Okay. All right, I'll play Crush.
Just no Surge?
No Surge.
Do I want to... I can either lose a clue... So I can lose a clue... to potentially quell something Michael casts after the Crush. You have not played your land this turn?
I have, right?
You have? Last turn you made 7.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So I don't think there's anything I particularly want to quell at 2 mana. It's likely Michael's just recasting the Oath of Nissa, and I'm don't really have a lot going on in my hand, so I'm just going to sack this clue.
Okay, and yeah, I'll just go ahead and use my mana.
Yep. I will play Tireless Tracker, play Lumbering Falls, get a clue. You can go. And then next turn we can set up this. Or these.
Excuse me, sorry.
You have a million cards in your hand.
I do. How
did that happen?
Okay, I'm going to play Mynissa.
This feels like a trap.
Could be.
So if I quell Nissa and Michael has another surge, then that just doesn't seem like it ends well for me. If I don't quell Nissa and you have another surge, then that's okay for me. If I don't quell Nissa and you have nothing, that also seems fine. Okay, I'm going to let this resolve.
Okay.
I assume you're flipping it.
I'll play Island Trigger. And then I'm going to plus Veggies. I will play Veggies.
I'm really most interested in quelling Den Protector. I'm not sure if I absolutely have to save it for this. Michael has enough mana. I'm just going to let that resolve. I think I have to focus on countering the high-impact cards at this point.
What if I have no high-impact cards? Then what happens?
Well, then I probably win. All my cards are great.
All right. I'm going to play an Elvish Visionary.
Sure. I'm gonna sack a clue. Go. Get a counter on my tracker. And I'm going to play Reflector Mage, bounce your Visionary, attack your Nissa.
Oop. Dice down.
And I'll play another Lumbering Falls, get a clue, pass the turn.
Right.
How many lands you got over there? A million? 11? You got like 8 or 9 cards in your hand?
Yeah.
9?
Yes.
The full 9?
It is 2020.
Yep.
I will play Elvish Visionary.
You cannot.
Oh, crap. Man. Okay.
Glad I'm not the only one who still does that.
All right, I'll just play Ulamog, I guess.
You have Ulamog in your deck. Jesus.
I've been staring at him for a long time this game. I'll target these two.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I'll play Collected Company.
Sure.
Okay, this is not it's not going well.
Okay.
I'll play Collected Company.
Sure.
Everyone I see playing this deck hits Reflector Mage off of all their Collected Companies.
But you did the last, like, 3 games. You can't complain.
I always do it in key.
You beat me up really badly. Let me have my fun. it's not even clear I'm going to win this game.
So I guess I will just put some spell quellers into play.
Okay. I might succumb to my cold before you kill me. I don't know. Excuse me.
Still 20, so that's good news.
Me too.
And at this point, I have to try to find a Reflector Mage for next turn. Which means drawing the most possible cards. So
you are dead to two Uwamog hits.
I'm going to play another Tireless Tracker.
You're a maniac.
And get two more clues.
Yes, my Din Protector.
You can go.
Yes. Yes, we're doing things. It's my time. All right. Trigger.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, I only hit one Reflector Mage. Still got two left. You know the bottom four, bottom eight cards of our deck?
Flip this up.
So we only have 16 left. Yeah, Oh, you cast the Crush Team, sure.
Yep. excuse me. Sorry. And I'm going to... I don't know. Could do anything. All right, I'll do that. And discard a forest. Go. I guess this is worse than a forest.
Hmm. Don't think I can win.
Yes.
So I certainly have to say, somehow I have to save this.
Did you chump block my Uwamog? I was a little too excited. I don't remember what you did.
Oh, no. I should be at 10.
Okay.
Yeah. That was largely irrelevant.
It's half your life total, Ross. It's not irrelevant.
I'll play a Duskwatch Recruiter.
Good start.
And so I guess, so you cast five, you can cast Uwamog next turn.
And sure then
exile some blockers and you have lethal damage. So
what's my plan? Mill you out? Kill you? Could be anything.
I'll pass the turn.
Okay.
I think I have to jump block with these so that the Uwamog doesn't take my better cards.
Okay, I think I just want to lead on an attack. So that's what I'm going to do. Go to 8.
Yep.
Gonna cast Uwamog. Target your
two lumbering poles.
I don't know. So you can't animate one and company. Not 20. Yeah, sure. Target your two lumbering poles.
I don't think I can afford to keep those around, so I'll float blue-green.
Okay. Go.
Still in second main. I'll play a spell caller. Still good end step.
Mm-hmm.
End step will play a spell caller.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. Reflector Mage.
Sure.
Bounce Ulamog. Attack for 4.
16.
And play a Tireless Tracker.
Sure.
You can go.
All right. Play Anticipate.
Yep.
Maybe with that Send to Sleep. Oh, yeah, there it is. Boom. Well, yeah. I want to reveal it. Show Ross that he's dead. Check out that one next to my name. We did it.
Okay, back for game 5. And I have another very speculative hand, but it has 2 of the most important features of our deck in this matchup, so I'm going to keep.
I think my hand's a little sketchy too, but I'm feeling a little more confident. I'm ready to go.
Okay, Prayer Restraint.
Okay. All right, not bad, not bad. Your turn.
Selfless Spirit.
Okay. All right, I guess we'll just get our Visionary on.
Yeah.
Your turn.
Attack for 2.
Yep.
You're at 18.
Yep.
I played Selfless Spirit in case you wanted to chump block.
Yes.
Yeah.
Doesn't have Spoke Weller. This is great. Don't. We're setting up. Go.
Attack for 4.
14?
Yep. You can go.
Crap.
Just have nothing.
They always have 2-drop, 3-drop company.
I didn't have a 3-drop. I didn't have Spellqualler.
Had a 2-drop. All right. I think I should do this right now. It gives me the most options. It's like maybe I can like hit Dispel and punish Ross, and that'd be great. And if I don't hit, then I can just like use my mana and brace for impact. So I'm gonna play this bait.
Sure.
It's not bad either, I guess. I'm not sure playing this card is better than just playing this, though. I don't think it is. But I do think it is the best card in these 3. Because it can still let me like slow the game down a little bit to set up these 2 cards. So I'm going to take this one. And then I'm going to play a Island and Nissa's Pilgrimage.
Sure. All
right. Spellmaster. And then it's your turn. Maybe I have to discard? Let me check. How did you just do nothing? What happened? You did have nothing. It's always a lie. But this time you had nothing.
Attack.
That's why you didn't sigh, because you actually had nothing. 4. Okay, I have to discard a forest.
Yeah.
Sure, 14.
10?
10, excuse me.
You can go.
It's an interesting draw. I will play Noose Constrictor.
Yep.
Okay. Nissa.
Yep.
This is going way too well. What is going on? All right.
This is not going how I had planned.
Trigger.
Yep.
Wow, this deck is great. Okay. I'm at 10?
Yes.
All right, I'm still scared I might randomly die, so I'm going to make a shot. Go. You just untapped. You didn't use your mana. You didn't use your mana 2 turns in a row. What is in your hand?
How many cards in your hand?
Six.
So I know that you found three forests in your hand off the two pilgrimage. You discarded one, and you've certainly played more of them. I think I know about like one forest. That's...
You know two. I think.
Okay.
Because I found another one.
Sure. So I can attack with Advocate and use Selfless Spirit to keep it alive.
Sounds great.
If I send both of these at Nyssa, then... well, my guess is it's likely like this, because you know that I'm sacrificing here, because you've made that block. That's a weird block.
Why is that a weird block?
Because you're just throwing away a Shia.
No, I'm not.
Or I guess you're
just past priority.
Yeah, you're just willing to make those trades. So, am I willing to make those trades? Getting Noose Constrictor off the board seems pretty good, but losing my Advocate for it seems pretty bad. You're 10. Definitely going to need to draw something to get out of this. I could play this pre-combat, at which point the blocks that I laid out are probably what happens, and then I get Visionary and a card for free. But that doesn't seem all that great. I think Michael is going to be able to clog the ground a bit on his next turn. Maybe not. He needs a Visionary or Den Protector to do that. Could Den Protector back the Noose Constrictor? Okay, I don't think losing my Advocate is good. So, mix of Den Protector on Noose Constrictor. So I'm going to play the Selfless Spirit, and I'm going to send both at Nyssa.
I don't really think this changes anything. It just forces me to discard a land Noose Constrictor. And it forces the Selfless Spirit. So, I mean, I could just go like this. And then just trade... Yeah, I guess this is just better for me. Yeah. Okay, yeah. I'll block like this, and then I'll discard.
Okay. There's no reason to sacrifice this one to keep a tapped one around, so... I will pass. I guess maybe I should have just attacked with Advocate then. Yeah.
That took
too long to figure out. I think I should have just attacked with Advocate. Then I'd have two spirits to potentially kill Nyssa next turn.
This does not untap.
Yeah, Skyline... yeah, maybe I should have just played Selfless Spirit. Go.
Oath.
Sure.
Ooh, baby. There's Ulamog. Alright, I just want to Ulamog you. Let's part the water veil. This is probably getting countered, but...
Yeah, I will negate part the water veil.
Okay. Go ahead.
Both at Nyssa?
Yeah, definitely willing to jump to keep Nyssa around, so.
And you can go. Yeah, should have just played Selfless Spirit with no attack the previous turn. Still don't think I'd be in good shape because of the Ulamog, but...
Plus... Ooh. Oh me, oh my. All right, let's try this again. Part the water veil.
I only get it.
You have one card left?
Yep.
Oh, whatever, Dispel.
Cool, take a point.
All right.
I'm at 19. and go. Crack this of Wallen Wilds. Is there any reason to do that? Probably not. Now that I've used my counter spells, I think I'll just keep it in play in case I draw Tireless Tracker.
Yep, makes sense.
And you have 9 mana in play, and Ulamog costs 10.
Correct.
So I can hold this, but I don't think that really does anything. I think if I actually get somewhat aggressive, I have the potential to draw a series of top decks that can win this game. So I will Reflector Mage Noose Constrictor.
Sure.
And now I might just attack Michael for 6. Because it's 4 damage versus the Nissa. So if I only bring Michael to 8, presumably Ulamog comes down, exiles these two, and I'd have to like draw Collected Company into Reflector Mage plus something, and then Michael probably doesn't... If he doesn't have Crush, then I might be able to win that game through Deuce Constrictor the next turn, whereas through like Ashaya and stuff, I probably can't. And if I bring Michael to 4, I don't have the option of winning next turn. So I think if I bring Michael to 2... I'd be willing to attack him, but I still think I want to kill the Nissa. So you go to 8. You can go.
And you should leave a blue source up, right?
Mm. Yeah, yeah. You are very correct.
All right. Let's see here.
As to help, if Michael decides to crush me, then I have Spellqueller up. Yep. So.
Okay, I'm just gonna play face down, get back a forest, and then Surge Crush. Go.
I'll take a point. Go to 18.
Yep.
Just want to deal some damage. Really needed a good draw there. Attack you to 6.
Yep.
And I will... Draw Tireless Tracker. Sack that, get a clue, sack it. Yeah, I'll play this land. You can go. So if I draw a Tireless Tracker, I can cast it, sack Evolving Wilds, get a clue, sack it, and then potentially draw a land and play a 3-mana card if I need to do that.
All right, attack you.
You don't think the extra clue is ever going to be relevant? I'm at 10.
Play... Maybe I should do this pre-combat. Eh, whatever. All right, play Ulamog, hit Prairie Stream, Spellqueller.
Really needed a Lumbering Falls this game.
Go.
And now my mana is strained enough that I think I need to sacrifice this. And I'll get an island. Yeah, if I was planning on sacking the Evolving Wilds, it's probably maybe should have held the land, but... These are all very minor things. Yeah, bounce the Ulamog.
Yep.
And you can go.
Yep. All right. Attack.
I'll go to 2.
And play Oath.
Assume I'm just getting crushed.
Yeah. Miss. Crush, play Nissa, get a Forest Transform.
This
play
is in your hand?
Yeah, play Noose Constrictor, make a Shaya.
And yeah, even if I play all three of these, Bounce, Octopus, untap Ulamog, hit two of my blockers, and have two attackers to my one blocker. So I'm dead.
Yep. All right, back here for the conclusion of Green Blue Crush versus Bant Company. Yeah, my deck was really hard to play. One of the first three games, I'm sure I punted. I think it was game three. I kind of traced. Like, I talked a lot about whether I should chump block with Nissa or not.
Yeah.
Because I was really afraid of, like, going down to six, I think. And then, like, I thought a combination of, like, Company plus, like, Reflector Mage or some other kind of interaction would be enough to kill me. And as it turned out, like, Ross didn't have that stuff, but then, like, he just played a normal game with me for a little while, and I just got grounded out.
Yeah, he just didn't have enough to take over following the Crush, so which is sort of the prerequisite for setting up a Crush of Tentacles and making sure you're winning that style of game in the first place. And if you need to take risks to do so, then those are necessary risks in that part of the game, and so that was probably a necessary risk you had to take.
Yeah. But I don't know, like, again, like, I'm sure I played pretty bad, but it seems tough to, like, find a window to try to get your Den Protector down to start assembling your lock because Spellcoiler is so effective against Den Protector.
This deck, it's a ramp deck, and we've seen ramp decks before that typically just get to their 7, 8, 10 mana, play their big thing, and that thing takes over the game. Maybe you, like, flashback K-Return of a Worldbreaker, or you get to start casting Emrakul, sacrificing Sanctum, maybe not Emrakul, but Ulamog, sacrifice Sanctum, find another Ulamog.
Yeah.
Maybe you go all the way to Emrakul. And then while this deck does have the one Ulamog, you're typically ramping, playing something big like a Crush to reset, and then you still have to do more. And so there's a lot more planning that is involved in the early turns to make sure that even after your Crush, you're still in good shape, and that certainly makes the deck a lot harder to play.
Yeah, it's super tricky. Like, I'm sure I didn't give it justice. Can definitely see how, like, this match would be pretty hard, but I'm sure this deck is fantastic against, like, all the mid-range decks.
Yeah, I can definitely see that. Any deck that lets you set up is generally going to be favorable unless they're doing something more powerful than you, and you're not really a deck that's that vulnerable to Emrakul.
Kind of. You can, like, you know, spew off Crushes and, like, give them back their Emrakul, and you can, like, play face-up Den Protectors.
So maybe you are a little bit.
It's not like a disaster, I bet, but, you know, I'm sure the games are tough.
Yeah, I have to imagine in those matchups you end up winning with Part the Water Veil a lot. You just set up these huge turns where the game goes from you're maybe slightly behind to the game ending in your favor, which is pretty sweet. I like decks that do that.
Yeah, you're also, like, a much harder ramp deck than the Emrakul decks. Like, they're trying to, like, set up with Delirium and a bunch of card types to power up Emrakul, and you're actually just putting lands on the battlefield, so maybe that gives you just an advantage straight up there, and you know, you have access to more counter magic post board since you're a straight blue green deck. But
definitely,
yeah. I mean, I like what the deck is doing. I'm too stupid to play against Bant Company. The Noose Constrictors definitely help post board. They take a lot of pressure away from the flyers, and just like letting you discard a card to fight their 2/3s is powerful.
Yeah, so. Very good with Pilgrimage. You usually have an extra land or two lying around, and you only need one card to trump both Selfless Spirit and Spellqueller on the battlefield. So definitely a nice addition in the post-board games, and we saw it do a lot of heavy lifting there. Even if it didn't seem like it, it was certainly something that I never wanted to see from my side of things.
Yeah, like, even it, well, of course it's hard to see the effect because Ross has never, or, well, it happened a couple times actually that he put himself into combat, but, like,
I tried sometimes, it didn't work out.
Yeah, generally speaking, like, they're just gonna, Noose Constrictor's just gonna make your opponent stare at you, so it's, like, not a direct impact, but it's there.
Yeah. That was for your benefit. Now you can see what happens when you attack it in Noose Constrictor all willy-nilly, like, it doesn't end well.
Usually Noose Constrictor just stares at things.
Yeah.
And that's fine. That's exactly what you need. You just need some time to set up.
You leave the snakes alone. Like, you don't know if they're poisonous, so then when you see one in your garden, you just sort of leave it be.
I'm pretty sure this one isn't poisonous. It just strangles you.
Yeah. Well, but that's still not good. You just don't know. And you don't want to find out.
So you'd be willing to, like, find out. I don't understand your logic.
Well, I was willing to find out.
You're either going to get killed by poison or you're going to get strangled. Like, why do you want to find out at all?
Some snakes are harmless.
Oh.
Some of them are fine. Mm. So, and I'd rather find out in a fantasy game than in real life.
True.
The stakes are a lot higher.
Pretty sure this one's, like, chilling around like a skull or something. So
yeah, that's already a bad sign.
pretty good sign that it might be dangerous.
Yep.
Yeah, you were playing boring Bant Company. You beat me up three times.
Yeah, Bant Company is what it is. This is just the test for the deck. And even though I won the set 3-2, you can definitely see some promise in the deck. You're definitely going to need to put some work into it so that you sort of know how to set up your big payoff cards. Although Ulamog didn't really need a lot of help.
So no, that's still a nice one.
And I like it as a singleton because you tear through your deck a lot with the Anticipates and all your ramp spells and Oath of Nissa and keep casting it after Crush. And then it's this one big button at the end that means that I, as an aggressive deck, just can't sit back and say that I always have the trumps. Yep. Ulamog definitely stops that. Maybe you can Clashables it. You don't really want to bring an Ogedai's Command just for it. And even countering it when you're a four Dem Predictor deck is not a great solution.
Yeah,
you need something like Summary Dismissal.
It's easy to assume that decks like these would be more like leading on Negate harder, and so Ulamog is kind of a nice way to go over the top of that. But yeah, these are both sweet decks. Could definitely play them in Richmond this weekend, which is where we will be. Spoiler, I'm not going to be playing any of these decks. I have a love. I'm going to keep fostering that love for Team or Emerge. But
personally, I don't know what I'm going to play in Richmond at this point. We'll see. I have Modern all set, so I know what I'm playing in Modern.
I'm clueless in Modern,
we'll put some time into Standard. Maybe I end up playing Green Blue Crush. I definitely it's stuff up. It may not seem like a deck that's up my alley, but
it doesn't. Not at all.
I would not mind playing that deck.
I don't think he's gonna play it, but anyways, you can see this weekend in Richmond if Ross Merriam plays Green Blue Crush, even though I doubt it. But
now I'm just gonna do it to spite him.
Yeah, I know. We'll be there at Standard. Ryan Overturf, Matthias Hunt, going to be taking a little break away from their usual Modern action to bring us some Standard. Should be a lot of fun. Pretty close to us, which is a super nice change of pace.
After Syracuse, New Jersey, Indianapolis, I'm ready for a nice short, what is it, like a three-hour drive?
Yeah, I think it's like 3 hours, so it's not bad.
That feels fantastic. I'm looking forward to it.
Yep. Should be a lot of fun. Come say hello to us. Play some Standard, watch it.
Get some great food. Richmond has great food.
Didn't know that, but that's cool.
Yeah.
All right.
I've only been there once, but I was really impressed.
Dope. Well, maybe you can show us where the good food is.
I will do that, or I'll try, as I do every week.
It's been like a month, but and it's starting to come back to me where we just go on and on and on. Like, I try to close the video out, and you're like, let's just talk about the food of Richmond. And
sure. All right, the Edgar Allan Poe Museum, that's also in Richmond,
just
walking
pass it
distance
off.
From
I'm,
the site.
I'm done. I'm done. I'll see y'all in Richmond.
Okay. I think that means I'm done, too. I'll see you in Richmond as well. You can come back and see us next week.